back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. This is Boss Vision, where I share with you all beauty, fitness, hauls, and everything you need to know about making candles. In today's video, we're going to be doing another candle wick holder review. In my last wick holder review, I shared with you all how to use the double wick custom wick holder from Lifestyle 3D Printing. If you haven't seen that video, I would say just click this link right here. It'll take you straight to it. I use the double wick in my Oxford jars right here. This is Love Bomb. It is heavenly. It's an exotic blend of raspberry, cantaloupe, and kumquat. You guys would love it. You gotta check out senseofvision.com. I'll link it down below. As you can see, it has two wicks here, and they were perfectly placed because of the custom wick holders from Lifestyle 3D Style Printing. So after that last review, I decided to reach out to the owner of Lifestyle 3D Printing for the triple wick custom wick holders, because as you all know, I make a lot of the Dream Vessels Zen tins, these tins here, and I like to use three wicks in these, and it's been a pain, to be honest, to use skewers and clothespins just to get this lined up. Super crafty. You have to be very, very technical to get that to work. So the owner was so nice to send me over a custom three wick holder for my Zen 10. So this is perfect. I've already tried it out. I'll just show you guys here. It fits perfectly like a glove. I'm super excited. Yes, all I did was email him the custom preferences that I would need regarding the diameter, and it does help if you just copy all those measurements from the site where you purchased them and paste them in the email so that you make sure you don't get anything wrong. Yeah, so I just copied and pasted that and it was perfect, and then he sent these over. Super fast shipping. He sent them in it was about less than 3 days when you get it, and he does design these custom, so that's very impressive. I'll link all this information down below. Okay guys, I just want to give you a quick overview of what to expect when you do click on that link. So as you can see here, this is their bestseller, the custom wooden or cotton wick holders and centering tools for single, double, and triple wicks, which is super impressive. And I love that he mentions that you have to reach out to him directly before you buy for sizing details, because he does specialize in customizations, which is definitely great for situations where you have a unique jar. As you can see, people have had some great experiences, so I'm looking forward to trying this out today. So in today's video, I'm gonna be taking you guys with me out step by step on how I make my secret honey vanilla candles. Yes, I'm revealing my secret recipe to share with you all, and hopefully this does work for you too, because it has been amazing. People have been loving honey vanilla. It's been selling like crazy, and honestly, I don't just use honey vanilla fragrance. I add a few extra things, so I wanted to share with you guys my secrets. So definitely stay tuned for the video, and if you do like videos like this, please make sure you give it a thumbs up and definitely subscribe so you don't miss out on anything else that I post. All right, let's just jump right into it.
Okay guys, here's an overview of everything that you'll need to make this amazing candle. First, you'll need a thermometer, and then you'll need a rectangular spatula. I use this for chopping up the wax as well as stirring in the fragrance oil. Here's some wick trimmers for after it's solidified and you want to trim down those wicks and lit up. Here's some gloves. You need those for when you use the wax and fragrance oil. I get these little disposable cups here from Chipotle, but you're welcome to use any disposable thing you like. And I would just clean it out with alcohol before I add fragrance oil. And then here is a specific candle scale. Yes, I don't use a kitchen scale. I use this precise candle scale with all three numbers here. So instead of saying like 2.5, it'll say 2.53. super technical. And I use alcohol for cleanup, and then I use this what is this called, like this little oven mitt here to set down my pouring pitcher on to cool after it has been, you know, the wax is melted. And then here's my pouring pitcher. Yeah, so this is from the Wet and Wet Co. I love it. I use it way too much. I need to buy the bigger one. But yeah, I got it as a free thing when I ordered a crap ton of wax once. So yeah, I need to buy a bigger one, but it is amazing. And then, as I said before, we're gonna be using these custom three wick wick holders for my Zen tent here. Isn't that beautiful? The beautiful gold. And it just fits in there perfect, guys. Like, just perfect. And then we're gonna be using my hot glue gun just to glue in the wicks. And we're using the CD10 pre-tab wicks. I get these from Candle Science. They're amazing for coconut wax, which is what we're using as well. Coconut apricot cream, heaven, heaven. Luxurious and creamy, you guys will love it. And then I'm gonna be using my double burning method. So I just have a little pot with very little bit of water, and then now I'm just gonna turn that on now. All right, here I'm just gonna go ahead and add in those three wicks. I wanted to show you guys how I apply them with hot glue. Now that the wicks have been applied, I wanted to go ahead and add in the wick holder. Super fun and much easier than using skewers and clothespins. Next, we're moving on to the wax. I'm adding in 10 ounces of wax for this candle. I'm just taking the wax and adding it to my pot for that double burning method and letting that melt down until we get up to 190. Now for the fun part. Yes, I'm so excited to share with you all my secret recipe that's been selling like crazy. So I use three different ingredients to make this honey vanilla candle. I start out with just the original honey vanilla from Candles and Supplies, which I'll link down below. Do about 0.5 of that. And then I go in with sugar cookie. Yes, that is definitely my secret ingredient. It adds an extra decadent fragrance to it, and it makes it taste really, well, smell really sweet, not taste. So next I'm going to go ahead and add in 0.2 ounces of Very Vanilla. This is another secret weapon for me. It adds an extra oomph to the candle, and in my opinion, makes the candle last longer with that lingering vanilla scent. So I always incorporate 0.2 of that. Back to the wax. Yes, so as you can see, it's melting down beautifully. Yep, so it got up to about 186, and I wanted to get it up a little higher, so I just waited to get it up to around 190 and then took it off of the heat. Here, I'm just gonna go ahead and add in the fragrance oil and mix for 2 minutes. So I set my Apple Watch for 2 minutes and I just go for it. All right, so once that timer is done, I go ahead and pour.
What we do here is go back.
Okay guys, we're back. It's been a few hours, so I just wanted to go ahead and trim the wicks and show you guys how well the wicks performed with this custom 3-wick holder from Lifestyle Custom 3D Printing. So yeah, let's just jump right into it. As you all saw in the video, I went ahead and added some clothespins because the wicks were kind of like moving. It could have been my placement, and it could be the fact that this wick holder doesn't have like, it's not really giving me a good place to put it, to be realistic. I mean, it's working, but it's just not like stuck and still, but you know, it works better than them skewers that I was doing. That took forever. I used to do this, guys. I used to have to roll up the wicks, which is a nightmare. Let's just see what we got. Perfect. Okay, awesome. I'll show you guys here before I cut the wicks. Yep, as you can see, they performed really well. So I'm just gonna go ahead and trim them. Guys, here's the final product. I wanted to go ahead and dim the light so you could see it. But yeah, this is a perfect candle. I'll insert pictures as well so you can see it. Yes, and it was less of a headache with 3 wicks. Because usually, I don't know if you've seen my other videos, but I have to roll the skewer down and add a clothespin. So overall, I would give it a 9 out of 10 just because of the fact I had to add clothespins. But other than that, phenomenal. I love how custom it is, you know, because we have to make a lot of candles and the best thing to do is to simplify that process in any way. So yeah, like I said before, make sure you check out Lifestyle Custom 3D Printing. I'll put the link in the description box down below. And if you do like videos like this, please make sure you give it a thumbs up and definitely subscribe so you don't miss out on anything else that I post. All right, I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, your week, your next hour, just living your purpose and love life. Okay, bye.